As the consequence of the leveling of coronavirus cases in India, the Maharashtra government on Friday declared that it will resume all strict sports beginning October 7th, which is the primary day of Navaratri. All sanctuaries in Maharashtra to be returned from October 7th, the primary day of Navaratri, and advised the residents to stringently keep coronavirus limitations. After the first COVID wave disappeared, sports in strict love were resumed in Maharashtra in November last year. Yet, they were closed down again for individuals after the subsequent wave began in the state in walk of 2021. The stomach enjoyed very much during the COVID period, but the hungry eyes were eager to have darshan of goddesses Durga during the sacred period of Navaratri after a period of 2 years as the temples were closed. What is the significance of offering OT to a goddess? The puja of goddesses should be concluded by offering her a khana and a sari. This ritual is performed to invoke her nirguna, non-materialized form to assume a saguna form to bring about her spiritual progress or welfare. All panchopachar pujan are associated with the nirguna form of God. When offering the OT, the prayer unto the goddesses asking her to manifest her nirgunatva activated through the panchopachara pujan performed before it helps her manifest in the saguna form. A ritual of offering a sari and a khana is called as OT bharni. The correct method of offering OT to a goddess. The sari offered to the goddesses should be preferably made of cotton or silk fabric because when compared to other fabrics, these fabrics have a better capacity to attract and retain the sattvic frequencies emanating from the goddesses. Retain the sattvic frequencies emanating from the goddesses. Place the sari in a plate along with a khana, coconut and some rice. Place the coconut with the trap towards the goddesses. Stand in front of the goddesses with the palms cupped at the chest level. Pray with utmost bhav, spiritual emotion to the goddesses to bless you with chaitanya and for spiritual progress. This will help in activation of the Daivi Tattva. After offering all the substances from the OT at the feet of the goddesses, place some grains of rice on them. If possible, the woman offering the OT, only a married woman, has the right to offer it, should wear the sari offered to the goddesses and consume the coconut as prasad, holy sacrament. The subtle process in performing the ritual of OT, bharani and its merits. The goddess's principle is attracted towards the tuft of the coconut. The coconut helps the principal permeate into the sari and the khana. Consequently, the frequencies emanating from the tuft of the coconut form a protective shield around the body of the individual performing the worship. With the help of the prithvi tattva from the cloth, waves of sattvic component are emanated. These waves, with the help of apatattva from the coconut water, gain momentum and become functional. As a result, a protective sheath of these waves is formed around the body of the worshipper. The waves of sattva component, the god sattva, which permeate the sari and the khana, help in purifying the pranadeha, vital body, and pranamaya kosha, vital energy sheath of the worshipper. The mudra posture of standing with cupped palms at the chest level helps in activating the chandranadi in the body of the worshipper. It also helps in increasing satta particles in the manomaya kosha, resulting in mental peace. This mudra is ideal to make the worshipper humble in front of the goddesses. Sattva component waves emanating from the fingers of the goddesses enter the body of the worshipper. This results in activation of Anahata chakra and helps in awakening the bhava of the worshipper towards the goddesses of worship. It further helps in purification of his gross and subtle bodies. The greater the bhava of the worshipper towards the goddesses, the longer the sattva component obtained from the puja of the worshipper. Since rice grains are all encompassing, they are in the forefront in absorbing the emanating chaitanya. That is why they play a significant role in the ritual of OT. What is the benefit of offering specific color sari and khan offered to the goddesses? Offering a sari and khana of a specific color known to attract maximum waves of a specific goddess activates the devi tattva in the individual in the least possible time. The table ahead gives names of goddesses and color which attracts the principle that goddesses, that is colors associated with the principle of the goddesses in the later, in the least possible time and in maximum proportion. Why is it beneficial to offer a 9-yard sari instead of a 5-yard one to a goddess? When a worshipper with bhav for a goddess and performing samasti sadhana according to Guru Kripa Yoga, path of Guru's grace, offers OT, the color of the sari does not matter, because anyway the worshipper derives the expected benefit because of her bhav. However, since for seekers in the preliminary stage or for those performing sadhana of karmakanda, spiritual practice of rites, rituals and observances performed at the physical level, every act should be as per the customs. For them, it is more appropriate to offer a 9-yard sari to the goddesses instead of a 5-yard one. Offering a 9-yard sari to a goddess symbolizes the function of the goddesses as per the need of the worshipper through her 9 forms. The 9-yard sari represents the functioning of the goddesses as per the need of the worshipper through her 9 forms. The 9-yard sari represents the functioning of the goddesses through her 9 forms. Offering a 9-yard sari thus implies invoking the basic Nirguna Shakti, which encompasses all the forms of Devi Tattva, to manifest in all her 9 forms to perform the required mission. The number 9 represents the 9 main forms of Sri Durga Devi. Why is the khana offered to a goddess folded in the shape of a triangle? The triangle is associated with the Ichha Shakti, energy of the will of deity Brahma, and the trinity of deities Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. The waves of Ichha Shakti from the universe too flow in a triangle path, moving from right to left. Offering a khan wrapped in a triangular manner to a goddess means strengthening of the Ichha Shakti of Sri Durga Devi and seeking her grace with the intention of making spiritual progress.